It's people in the ghetto who don't have the same advantage that other people have. But what they can do, they can fight. And, you know, and they were two brothers. Both of them in the Olympics. Both of them gold medal. And, you know, I kind of felt that I could do it. Because, you know, I had people say, y'all too dumb to be champion. You can't do that. But, you know, back at that time, you had Leon Spence, but then you had Rocky too. And so the black with the white boy who everybody thought was crazy, but he won too. So it inspired people. Anytime stuff something like come on TV, it's inspiring somebody out there who don't have the money, who don't have the means, don't have the education that other people have. But you know, what you do have, you have the will. So when kids have the will and they have people to talk to them and let them know that you can make it too. Everybody's talent is not in the same level.
Do you think it's a lack of focus on the amateurs
Of course it is. It hurt the program when you don't show boxing in a prime time where little kids to watch. Wait kids stand up 12 o'clock or 1 o'clock watching boxing. And it's pay-per-view. If you ain't got no money, then that means that none of the poor kids gonna be able to see it. Yeah. Only thing they gonna hear somebody talking about it. Then they talk about it, they ain't gonna hold on to it. And if they see it on TV, they say, oh man, I can do that.
To piggyback off of that then, do you think, because I remember when I was a kid growing up, boxing was on channel, I'm on NBC, ABC, in the afternoon, that's how I fell in love with sports. So do you think that boxing needs to go back to maybe being shown in the afternoon?
Of course. So you gotta understand, what happened in boxing? Most people follow boxing people who are poor. You got, I'm talking, in all race car drivers, all these tough sports, you're gonna say, well, who do it there? So the whole big thing is that at that time it was Howard Cosell. It was Howard Cosell, baby. Because it was his baby, he ran the whole program. So you know what? He competed with everybody. You know, they said, man, how in the world boxing don't compete with football? They did at the time I came up, they showed it football. Matter of fact, I boxed, and I opened it up for football. Before every Super Bowl, they had me 2 times before Super Bowl. People ask how you get popular, how the ABC contract. So if there's nobody give an opportunity, when nobody knows. Everybody know you around the world. I was on ABC talking. Everybody had ABC. And so, you know, if somebody got to really love the program, it's the one got the pick. They don't even put none of the fighters on the Olympics. That way, I didn't see no Olympic fighters. Everybody needs to know who made the Olympic team. So everybody needs to know that these guys who make the Olympic team are the ones that don't be winning. I told you, we got to come back and start, say, look, we got to let people know who's coming. I don't nobody want to just pay some pay-per-views or somebody want to know. But when everybody ask everybody, they say, well, man, we want you to do an Olympic, man. We want you to do an Olympic. We want you. We knew you were going to be it. Like that, and I did.
So can we get a picture?
And last thing for me, welterweights. Errol Spence, Keith Thurman, Danny Garcia, Sean Porter. Who you see going the furthest in the welterweight division?
Well, you know, man, it's just a matter of opinion, man. You got to put people in there and let them fight each other. I don't care. I'm talking, somehow, everybody always say, you fought everybody. I said, well, yeah, there's a why. I wanted to know who the best was. I said, so if you want to know the best, you have to fight the best.
That's right.
So that's the whole thing of boxing about. And you know, I kind of like how UFC is. It don't make no difference how many times a guy lose. They good fighters. They putting them on.
Yeah.
I'm like, you know, I'm saying styles make fights. But styles make fights. At any given time, that guy fight the guy with the wrong style. He can beat that guy.
Nate Diaz choked out Conor McGregor.
I told you, this is what it is. Styles they fight. Yeah. I'm telling you, you're not on loser because you fought the style and it didn't work. You know, you come back and see if we make adjustments. I'm very proud because I make adjustments. Okay, then you got me on that. I didn't know that. I go back and make adjustments, but I can beat you. And you got some people, they ain't gonna give you a chance either. Yeah. You know, some people ain't gonna give you a chance because the game of boxing is say, okay, you know, how did you get there? Somebody gave you a chance. I'm saying, you know what? Till you beat a champion, you ain't no champ. Till you beat a champion, it's anybody's opinion, I'm good. Everybody's supposed to say they're good. And you know, okay, then give somebody a chance. Get in there. This is our champion mate.
Do you think boxers today are too worried about protecting their undefeated record?
Don't get them started.
Right.
It's not about that because they don't supposed to control it. Whoever the commissioner control what you going to do in the WBA.
Right. Yeah.
I'm telling you, how you going to put it on the fighter? Right. You know what? The point of the matter is that your rules and regulations are supposed to change and hold somebody good. You know what? These are the rules and regulations. If you don't fight by these things, then we gonna take our belt.
The WBC tried to force Canelo to fight Golovkin. That didn't work.
He lost the belt, though. That's your speak. That's your speaking volume to you know what? Being all that you think you is, that you have to lose your belt because you won't fight the next guy that's in line. That's what boxing is all about. You know, I'm saying people don't realize it's about taking chance. You put yourself in a chance that somebody can beat you. But we in the world in life won everything anyway. Shoot. If I tell the people, I say, shit, they call me crybaby as a kid. I cry about everything. I got beat at everything. But I just didn't quit. Because I didn't quit, I become the only man who's been heavyweight champion 4 times. But you know what? It didn't look that way because, you know, but I was mad and all that, getting beat up. You know, but the point of the matter is that life is all adjustment. Do you quit? And so the whole big thing is just like I tell the people when in this event, this thing they get ready to induct me into
Hall of Fame.
Yep. So, get ready to induct me into that. The only thing I can tell them about is, look, man, I just didn't quit. My mama told me, if you don't quit, you eventually get to your destination. And that's what it's all about. You don't say, change it up for me to make it. No. You just don't quit. You keep working. And that's, you know, if you want to inspire people to be better, you can't. I ain't got to go through that. If you don't go through that, then you're not going to be qualified to be able to talk to somebody to tell them the truth. You're going to be full of a lot of lies. But the only one way you can get there is not quit. Go through whatever you need to go through and end it up. You've been together.
Who's the toughest guy you ever fought?
I'm a lot tougher. A lot of them are tough. You know, but the harder, I think, the white Muhammad Kwame. I lost 15 pounds in fight, fighting that guy trying to keep him off of me. You know, I'm the
guy by himself.
Yeah, it was just my 12th fucking fight. They throw me in there with this guy, and I'm like, I wasn't going to not fight him. Because
he had how many fights in 12?
12. And that was my 12th professional fight. Never been number 8 round. They talking about 15 round night. You know, 1 hour. That fight ended up 1 hour. I lost 15 pounds.
How do you do it?
Huh?
How?
I just didn't quit.
Yeah.
I prayed and then quit.
And George Foreman was a harder puncher than Mike Tyson?
Well, I wouldn't say he's a harder puncher than Mike Tyson, but he hit me one time. And my feet froze up like this, and I've never been hit like that before, and I remember coming back to the corner, asking did he knock all my teeth out. They say, you all right? And you know, when somebody just tell you all right real quick, you may not be all right.
My last question, Evander, who's your favorite UFC fighter? You mentioned that you like him. Do you have any? And
well, you know, I don't follow him much.
We have a couple pictures.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter @Secback. And you can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback.